Hey, what's up y'all? Week 1 of the Dyzee Migas Thread Challenge by Break Mission has just ended, where I will be selecting only one video to make it to the semi-final round of the top 10 thread style videos. With that said, I just want to say that I am completely blown away by the amount of video submissions. It's so amazing to see how many thread style breakers are out there. In my opinion, threads are the last style completely born out of the ciphers before the competition era took over, with moves and details so intricate it can only be truly appreciated in a small cipher within close proximity. With that said, I've watched every video submission and just wanted to give my overall opinion on what I'm looking for. For us, in Toronto, threads have always been about having that complex, illusionary, magical effect in breaking, where someone watching would be like, "What the heck just happened?" and need to rewind the video many times in order to figure out how it was done. So I was pretty much judging on how compelled I was to rewatch the videos. Part of having that magical effect is to use threads that are original, and also how clean and precise the threads are done and how it flows with the music, kinda like complex rap. With that said, out of all the video submissions, I was finally able to narrow it down to a handful of videos that really, really impressed me, which I will be doing a live reaction to the videos right now. Now, before I begin, I want to separate this into two categories. The first is world-renowned threaders, who in my opinion are the biggest thread style breakers in the hip-hop culture today. The second category are threaders that I've never seen or heard of until now, but have really impressed me. So let's start off with my reactions to the world-renowned threaders. First up, we have Jayhawk from Korea. This guy's been a threader for a long time. Dope threads. Did two entries. Let's see how it goes. Okay, first video. He's starting off with finger threads. Okay, yeah, finger threads is dope. Okay, right into his stuff. Nice thread. Boom. Threading. Nice, a crazy leg thread. Took it to another level. Oh, that was a sick thread. I saw that. And he brings it around. Oh, his foot's very complex and intricate. And the thread behind the back. Yeah. Okay, so let's check out Jayhawk's second video. And he comes in. Oh, nice flow. Oh, get it? His head kind of threaded through it. that was a dope thread from his elbow on the ground. A floor thread with his elbow. Oh, nice. Oh, a loop-de-loop thread. All right. Oh, dope. Very original thread. That's what I love about this. Boom. Very original thread. Nice with the Lego thread. Oh, the crazy leg thread again. I see it again. Two times. Nice. Oh, rolls in. And a little clap. Where's the thread? There it is. Boom. Oh, nice. All original threads. I love it. Very dope, Jayhawk. The next, also from Korea, we got none other than Jinjo Cruz, B-Boy Mold. Okay, side note, he told me that he used to look up to me back in the days. All right, let's see what he's got. Here we go. Oh yeah. Okay, very fast. What I love is the quickness and the preciseness of his threads. Oh, that was dope. The arm thread's bringing it down to the little Lego thread again. Nice. Where's the thread at? Nice, there's a little one right there. Okay, the arm wrap thread. Oh, broke it with his knee. Brought it down. Oh, thread to the ground. It's all puppet thread styles. Okay, brings it through, transition thread. Oh, the loop-de-loop. He's going back in. What's he gonna do? How's he gonna finish it? Oh, thread under thread. Oh, sick. Upside down thread. Oh, a lotus shoulder thread. Oh, but down. Okay. And how's he gonna finish? How's he gonna finish? Oh, and a little tiny spin around on his butt. Mold is a freaking nasty threader, ain't gonna lie. Of course, he is sick with it. Very dope, Mold. Let's see who's next. We got, the next one up is from Canada. His name is Magneto from the NON crew, but he's from the other side of Canada. But he's got actual threading tutorials online, and I've seen some really dope threads. So I like the concept threads that he has. Let's see what he's got. Okay, Magneto, let's go. Here he goes. Okay, starting with the standing threads. Okay, into the puppet threads. That's when you're threading underneath you. Okay. Doing transition roll through threads or pull through threads. Oh, now what's he gonna do? Oh, he jumps over. Basket thread. What's he gonna do? Basket thread again. To another coin drop and basket thread. And Ah, okay, okay. So what I liked about that is that he followed a concept. You know what I mean? Like the concept is the basket threads and he went with it all the way. Right, but I really like more complex illusionary threads where it goes thread to thread to thread to thread where you have to rewind it and be like, ah. But yeah, let's see who's next. We got Shunji. Okay, Shunji is from Mortal Kombat from Japan. And he's definitely a threader. Actually, a long time ago in B-Boy Summit 2000, he actually called me out in a circle. We went a couple of rounds. I guess it's because, you know, I'm a threader. He's a threader. So let's see how he goes. So, okay, let's see, Shunji, what you got? Okay, here we go. He goes in to the ground, straight into the threads. Oh, onto the shoulder threads. Oh, very tight, small. Oh, nice. Oh, what the? Oh, the flow is sick. Oh, right there. Oh, my goodness. That's the illusion threads I'm talking about where it's like you don't know how he's getting into it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Took his shoulder upside down threads to a whole new level. Is he going to finish it in a freeze? He's still going with all these tiny, intricate, little tiny threads that you can only see with the magnifying glass, but it's dope. Okay, oh, miniature, tiny threads, and what's he gonna finish with? Oh yeah, finish with a freeze. I love that, that's what I'm talking about. In all honesty, yeah, always finishing with a freeze is really important to me, very important, and he did that, and that's awesome. I think he spent too much time upside down on his shoulders and threads have to lead somewhere, but it was dope. He took shoulder upside down threads to a whole new level. You know, I don't even do it to that level. And he is the last of the world renowned threads. Now please allow me to show you my reaction to the threaders that I've never heard of before, but was blown away by. So first threader that I'd never heard of before is a guy named Amansik. And I'm not sure if that's his real name, but if it's his b-boy name, it's kind of dope because his name is Amansik, like the man sick, you know what I'm saying? So let's check him out. Okay. So this guy comes in, does a similar thread go down like me. Okay, he doesn't, that's an interesting thread right there, but it gets interesting where I really like the flow right here. Boom, 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 the Dyzee thread, boom, boom. Like the complex continuous flow right there is dope, like that. And what's, and he finishes with a freeze, a thread freeze. And that's, to me, that's perfect because he's doing all the complex threads and it's leading to somewhere. Now, I think that the final thread freeze and the threads before it could have had a better link. But nonetheless, what I liked about Amansik is that it was continuous threads. Okay, the next one, his name is B-Boy Chosen One. And I like the way that he put things together, like it was all within a B-boy formula, okay? So let's check him out. Here he goes. Starts with the top rock, like that, and then thread. Oh, and I have a move like this, but I like how he brings it kind of like a pattern, and then the little flexi arm thing, and how he changes onto the other side with the angle, threading through, drop to the ground. Okay, now the flexibility of threading over your head, but where's it gonna go? He's still threading, it's a little freeze. Okay, until transition, threading, and finish with a freeze. Okay, I like how it was, the storytelling of this whole round was nice because he put it within a formula and you can see him break down into different ideas of threads. I thought that was awesome. Okay, next one, we got a guy from the Philippines. Now I do know who he is and I've battled him before. His name is Gabster. Let's check him out and let's see how I react. Okay, here we go. So he's going down to the ground and he's doing legwork threads. That's what I like, into arm wrap threads. Okay, good, arm wrap threads. And then boom, into a freeze, tucks under, pulls it under, threads into like knee threads. Now puppet threads, it goes up. Now I don't see a thread. Okay, there's a thread, into arm, standing arm threads. Okay. Boom. What's he gonna do to finish? Oh, thread underneath. And then. Okay. And how's he gonna finish? Okay, there's a sitting thread. Oh, that was dope. Into a Dyzee thread. Oh, yeah, that's a very similar combo as mine, but it's dope. And how's he gonna finish? Okay, with a freeze. That's good. Now, it would have been doper if it was a thread freeze at the end. I think that overall he put a lot of threads into one round. I personally prefer the old school B-boy style where you're telling a story where it's like you start on top, you break it down, you do the footwork threads, maybe the arm wrap threads, then maybe the burn threads, then maybe the freeze threads, and you finish with a threading freeze. Personally, that's what I think is the best, because you know, you're telling a story, you see concept to concept to concept to concept. He had a lot of dope threads, but I think they could have been flowing together better. Okay, let's go to the next. Now this guy, I think this is also from India. His name is The Invincible A-Rock. And oh yeah, he is from India. So let's check it out, okay? I like how he's coming in with swag, okay? He's putting, that means he's doing it in the B-boy context, okay? Now, this is just like a basic pattern, but it's kind of foreshadowing that he's gonna thread, okay? Okay, does the knee thread, okay, he's bringing it to the ground, very nice. Threading out, I like how he rolled up and threaded like that, that's dope. With the hat thing was dope, okay? And he brings it, threads his hat again, and oh, that was a concept. See, I love that. I love when they do that, and you can see a concept, like a story within it, and I thought that was really awesome. He broke it down really nice. I really enjoyed the way he did it, like, and everything flowed a lot better and had a concept in it. Very sick. I really like that a lot. And yeah, that's hard to beat. So next one, we have a guy named Sheka from Spain. Okay, Sheka from Spain. Let's check him out. Here he goes. Okay, coming in. I like the music. Okay, arm threads standing. Oh, nice go down with the thread. Okay, nice. He brings it up. Oh, very original threads. That's nice thread. Okay, thread. Oh, small thread though. Brings it. Oh, threads on that side. Very good form. The form in here is dope. Like his feeling and boom. Oh, snap. Oh, snap. Not original. Oh, snap. Oh, into a pulse thread. Oh, and he brings it around with amazing exit. Threads to the ground. Okay. Sick. That was freaking insane. Threads out. And he's just flowing with the music still. Oh, and the swag. And the flavor, and walks out right after. That was nasty. That was freaking nasty. What I liked about what he just did, when he was threading, it was in those poses. Like, it was like thread to pose, thread to pose, thread to pose, thread to pose. And that's what I call thread burns, where every thread goes into like a next pose, the next pose. And that's what I really liked about it. And I didn't see anybody else doing that, but he did it, and I really, really enjoyed that. I thought that was sick. And the way he would exit out of it, you would think it's done, but he would exit out of it really sick. I had to add this guy. His name is Tanmoy Karmokar. Let's go. Very interesting. It's kind of like an experimental music kind of thing, but the way he's going to the music is like, it's very slow, but what I like about it is the flow, okay? It's flowing through his head, through his foot, very fluid, okay? Very fluid threads, that's what I really like about it, okay? Like I said, all street styles are welcome, right? I guess it's an experimental hip-hop style, okay? So he's doing sitting down threads. He's flowing out of everything really nicely, that's what I like. It's very fluid and watery, and that's why I had to include this onto someone who impressed me. The fluidity is very dope, and he's flowing with the music. Uh-huh. He's taking his time. I prefer it a little bit more faster. Oh, he's doing some holding his foot threads. Oh, oh, nice. I don't even know if that was a set. Like, I personally think that was all freestyle, and the way he flowed it was really dope. After this, all these guys are gonna be getting their name out as threaders around the world. I would love to see all these guys in a circle exchanging and battling to see who's got the illest threads in the game. That would be freaking nasty. So it was really difficult for me to choose a winner, since pretty much all the videos had elements which impressed me. I'll be posting this week's one winner with my commentary and explanation why I chose that video on the Dyzee Threads Instagram page. Also, I want to remind everyone that my Dyzee Threads Break-In sneaker is currently on pre-sale with free shipping worldwide until July 18th. I designed these sneakers for breaking, especially with threading in mind. It's lightweight, thin soles, so you don't get stuck in visually eye-drawing for that magical effect. This will be the only time you are able to select any or all of the 8 colorways. Only 3 of the top selling colors will be available to the general public. So click the web link on the @DyzzeeThreads Instagram channel bio to cop yours. To all my fellow threaders, now you know what I'm looking for and how my mind sees threads. Please do submit another next level thread style video. For the threaders I highlighted, please feel free to record another round, or if not, it's possible I might still choose your video for next week on the 18th, where I'll be selecting two videos for the top 10. Don't forget, in the end, it's the thread legend Migas who will be selecting the final winners for a total of $400 in cash prizes and giveaways. Thanks once again to Break Mission for putting this together. Good luck everyone, and may the best thread styles win! Breaking rules for life!